Are we broadcasting?
Well, there we go. I can mute it though.
It's white.
Okay, yep.
I kind of want to get over there with Bibi and have breakfast with Bibi. You can just look back. I'm not going to hold it for you. What you cooking?
Bird's a little spoiled.
What you cooking?
She was like, the other day, she was eating quite a bit because she was so active. Her weight was down a little, so we're trying to get her to eat one. Kelly had to like feed her one kibble at a time.
Yep.
One at a time.
Yep.
Yep, I've been known to do that too when we go to my dad's lake house.
What are you doing with her? What are you doing with her?
Getting her closer so they have breakfast together. Maybe.
Yeah.
Huh?
Right after I set the camera.
I'm sorry, I didn't know.
Yeah.
You eat your breakfast? Kelly, you might have to get food thrown on you.
I'm working on it.
It's all right. It's grains. Her breakfast consists mostly this grain mixture that I cook up with. Oh, let me rotate that. With different kinds of vegetables in it.
Okay, don't get up. Great to meet you. You're welcome anytime. We hope to see you again sometime.
You're really terrific.
And have safe travels. We'll keep posted of your proceedings. Bibi, it was so nice to meet you.
Would you guys be interested in t-shirts?
Oh, yeah, we have t-shirts. Yeah, we intended to give you t-shirts. I can.
No, not that. No, we got money.
Yeah.
Sure. We love them.
Purple, red.
Light. Yeah.
Cool.
Want to work some? Give some chip?
It was cooking.
Good to cooking, yeah, it's good, huh?
Yeah, we went up to double extra large, so we had small and double.
Right.
Yeah, XL would be good. Purple, obviously, since it's Bibi's car.
It was cooking.
Then we actually got extra purples because of that.
Sweet. Bibi,
I'm glad you remembered that.
Chip is.
Potatoes.
Potatoes, yeah, those are good too.
Chips were in your favorite color, but it's going to put that in.
Potatoes.
Potatoes, yeah. Okay. take kids, have a safe trip.
Okay.
Thanks so much.
See you later.
We have your email address.
Oh, yeah.
It was great meeting you, and I'm sure we'll see each other again.
No doubt about it.
Okay, bye-bye. Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.
Bye-bye, BB.
Bye-bye. Can y'all wait?
Bye-bye.
Einstein, can you get the door? So help, thank you.
Bye-bye.
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 That's a sweet bye-bye.
Bye-bye.
Bye-bye. Don't miss it.
Bye-bye.
She must have the food. She's already asked for yogurt, cooked fish, and potatoes.
Cooked fish and potatoes?
We need to run a buffet.
For sure.
It's okay.
I was thinking last night, I was wanting to see how neat it'd be to do like a bird road trip with like, with Einstein and BB and maybe another couple of gray owners, bird owners, and just getting like, do the houseboat thing and do the... Do a cabin in the woods or... And breakfast on a houseboat, yeah, buffet style.
I think he just, that's what he does when he like relaxes and turns his brain off. He thinks of all these things to do and creative ideas. He's a creative thinker.
I think it'd be fun. That'd be a real, we'll get a kick out of that, the birds and the destination and the people, the food. Cream and dime.
So who owns Shadow?
Sharon, right?
Yeah.
Awesome. We like the chips.
I might, you don't recall her last name.
Cream.
That name's not familiar.
She posts a lot of movie stuff, I think she gets on the chat.
Okay.
But she, Shadow's a big bird, it's like over 500 grams.
African gray?
Yeah.
Wow.
Awesome.
What do you want, BB?
Not that it's particularly good for her.
Yeah, awesome.
Yeah, it's good. I'll just pick out the pecans for her. BB, you want some pecans?
Ooh.
Want some cooking?
She'll get you some.
Yeah, we just get some pecans out of here.
Ooh, was that fun? Was it for me?
They got it cool.
Got it cool.
Not cool. Okay, guys.
I don't know what that is.
What, is it on your finger?
Yeah.
Was it on your?
You must have burned it. I thought you had some stuff.
It looks like a blister that...
Did you burn yourself with it on there?
I don't know. I don't feel anything.
There you go. Got it done.
Yeah, that typhoon was really hot.
Wow. Oh, I love this.
The shower probably made it white like that.
Here you go, baby. Want a nut? Yeah, let's put it over here. Go.
There's some cooking.
Some cooking.
Cooking in your breakfast.
Some cooking. It's good.
And the cooking, it went from a verb to a noun for baby. At least cooking. I want some cooking.
There you want some.
Yeah, well, go look in your breakfast.
Okay, so I noticed a lot of times we play back stuff. How do you get it to where...
There you want some.
Okay, you're broadcasting now. This is live. Then how do you play back stuff on the Ustream? I mean, because...
It like saves it.
Oh, okay. Then Ustream saves it.
Yeah, there's like an off-air thing where you can choose. You can pick... Selected videos. I think right now we just
need a little water because I got a little sugar in your table.
Oh, it doesn't. This is for Micah. Don't worry about it. It's, yeah, it looks like wood, but it's for Micah. And it's in, it,
not,
none,
not.
Nothing destroys this. I've had this table for 30 years.
Wow.
Awesome.
You need to change something you're already destroying.
Well, Einstein has kind of, yeah, messed up the edges, but, because it's, but, yeah, it's a hardy table.
So your whole food bowl is closer to this. For some reason, it seems to be the difference about what we're eating or not.
Okay, so Ustream decides what gets played back now.
If you can tell it what to play, or if it lacks recorded thing, you can hand select certain videos. But it's, you can't really pick, like, YouTube wants to play it, pick ones that are directed at someone. We have software, we can play other videos too.
Through Ustream, maybe you can just pick the video and it'll play it, and then put to Ustream and it's live.
Yeah.
And that's actually the best way to do it, though, because the quality is so much higher.
And that's how you do it with Ustream stuff too. Because, like, if you just use their broadcaster, then your, other options are ones that you can go with, it's kind of right from your camera and your mic to their website.
Okay.
But you can put some go-between and stuff first.
Yeah, I use a, the thing called Wirecast. It lets you, like, set up and compose the shot, and you see a preview of it while the live one's playing. And then you can click on it when it's ready to go, and it'll transition over. I think they use
Transition over to YouTube?
No, just transition the shot. Like, say we had a background with flowers or something, and we want to go to a cityscape, then you can set up the cityscape, put all the graphics in, and you can see the preview of it while the live one's playing. It's really kind of nice for, like, news and TV kind of broadcasting. They have, like, they call it virtual sets, where it's like a fake newsroom or something like that. Drop the shot in there. We didn't have very much success with it until we got a pretty decent camera. Because of, I think just the way it has probably more to do with lighting than anything. You have to throw so much light on the scene so that green screen has no shadows. Mm-hmm. You have to be just almost perfect. And by the time you got the light that high, it was probably a little too much for me. So we stopped doing the green screen for a while until we got our the green camera.
Really, it takes that much light.
Yeah, light seems to be the key for a lot of things, especially with green screen. Because if you almost have to have three-point lighting, because if you just have light from the front and the shadows mm-hmm. from her perch and from her everything, get that back, and then you can't get a good key, which that's what they call it, when it, you get the green consistent. So you kind of have to have one light coming in from like, the left angle, and then a light coming in from the right angle, and then a light from the front.
Yeah.
So three-point lighting, and like professionals usually do a fourth light actually behind the green screen, where they'll have to, outside of view of the camera, but a light that shines up behind the green screen to get that light.
See,
perfect.
This fundraiser video is going to be a disaster then. Because this girl who's orchestrating it, me, I don't know, maybe six or seven other people with dogs and cats and other birds, and she sent us all green screens and, said, but she hasn't said what kind of, she hasn't given that kind of instruction. And I'm supposed to get Einstein to dance in front of it. And you take into consideration several other people doing it.
Mm-hmm.
No one, it's not going to be consistent, I think, so.
Well, and it's kind of hard. One thing is, if, since if you're using like Adobe Premiere or some kind of software,
mm-hmm.
you got a lot more control because the software can work behind the scenes to make up for maybe lack of light.
Mm-hmm.
But the Wirecasting, that's real time, and when it's real time, you have a lot less room for error when it comes to the light. It has to be. In our case, it's like just the camera itself made a big difference.
Yeah.
Even that big camera I got, it doesn't really chroma key well unless you really open up the iris and bring a lot of light into it. But the broadcast camera, it's like a little gray dome looking thing, and it can zoom in and out and pan to left and right, up and down. but it's also kind of designed a lot better for low light, and so you can handle a lot lower light and still have a good result. Really happy with that camera. I probably need, at some point, going to go through some kind of audiovisual liquidation, because we've got equipment we just don't really use enough to justify holding on to it and put on eBay, at least get, you know, 75% of our
Oh,
and then we use that to make the DVD. And at some point, we'll probably get rid of that RV too, after we finish the road trip. We're not really necessarily RV people. But,
right.
And I don't know that necessarily we'll need it, maybe for all of these road trips, because a lot of my reason was we wanted a place to take DVD every night where it was the same. And she'd have some kind of consistency from night to night, especially with sleeping and retiring for the night. But now that she's, you know, been out dozens of times, she's, you know, doing these night things, that she's responded better than I thought she would, really. She really has. And so we were kind of erring on the side of caution, you know, we just don't know.
She's a very well-adjusted little birdie, I tell you.
It was a journey for her. I wish we had really documented from the time she was like more than 2 years old to now that she's come so far. But she was a little timid little thing when we first got her, and we've always babied her. She has no reason really to be scared of things, but they just, they come out of the egg that way, you know.
Yeah.
They have to overcome their fears.
Yeah. Einstein's pretty much the same way. I think the key is, as long as, you know, they're with us, they're fine. Like, we took Einstein to Austin to visit some people and stayed in their house, and you know, she was fine as long as she could stay with us. And later that night, we went to another friend's house. We all did for a party, and Einstein came with us in a little travel cage, and you know, we just kept her safe and put her in another room for a minute so that everybody could hear her talk, and she was just part of the. In fact, I think Einstein enjoys being with the party. She just, you know, enjoys it. So.
Yeah, I think that's the key there. I don't know how BG would handle being away from Kelly for very long, or from Kelly and I for very long.
Well, you know how we do it when we decide to go on vacation and break in a new center. Did Jeff tell you this?
No.
We take Einstein over for just a few hours, and we have, you know, we sit and socialize with the new people, and it's someone that we know and trust, and it's someone that we're good friends with, and it's someone who wants to do it too.
Mm-hmm.
You can't talk somebody into doing this. So anyway, we go over and we explain to them this process too, so that they know what they're getting into. So we go over, take Einstein, we go and visit, and then we come back home. And then maybe a week later, we go back over, we visit a short while, and then leave Einstein. It might be just like during the day, I'll take her over for a couple of hours.
That's a great idea.
And then leave Einstein so that people kind of get to know each other, and, you know, get to know Einstein. And then I'll bring her back, I'll go pick her up, tell her I'll be back, you know, I'll go home, do something, and then go back and pick her up. And then we'll go do that maybe another time if I feel like it's necessary. And then the third step is to go just one night. Leave her. I mean, we take cage, perch, the whole shebang. And this gives me an opportunity to tell people how to feed her, you know, and work it in slowly like that. So just overnight, 24 hours, and then we come back in. And then we do a weekend. Just two nights, three nights, a long weekend. And this may be a time when we may still be at home, or we may go ourselves on a short little trip,
mm-hmm.
and keep in touch and everything. And then by that time, Einstein knows the people, the people know Einstein, they know the routine, and you know, we feel good about it. And then it may be a week vacation or a 2 week vacation. And then that way we know everything's 99% chance Einstein's going to be adjusted, and the, you know, the people will know what to do. So
So, you know, and is it easy to leave her? No, but, you know, the way I look at it, I have to have a life, you know, too. And in a way, it's good for me to get away.
Oh, I'm sure.
At times, you know. Yeah, and do I get away and not think about her? No, you know, and like this last trip to France, I was texting a lot, you know, and back and forth to the sitter. But these people that, one of them is our neighbor, and Einstein adores him, just adores him. And
that helps a lot.
Yeah, regurgitates on his shoulder the whole 9 yards. I mean, just loves this guy. And but she's real nervous around Einstein, so all she does is basically feed Einstein, you know, clean up. And he drives for a company, so usually he's there. But there's times when he had to go on a trip, and so Einstein just gets kind of put in a cage, you know, for that duration. But and also I tell people, when you bring her into your home, you set the pace, whatever's convenient for you. I don't expect Einstein to be on her perch all day long, you know. So that's what this friend of mine did when we were in France. When she got up, fed Einstein breakfast, went and got dressed, and she works at home. She has a job where she works at home. Then kept Einstein in the cage eating breakfast, and then once she was all dressed and ready for her to start her day, then she'd bring Einstein out. You know, the way we do it, oh, Einstein's just with us, you know, that's a normal thing. But so Einstein has come to learn that whenever she goes, we call it going to camp, going on vacation. She really has to adjust and change her way of living too. Okay, now what are these people going to have me do? She knows she'll be safe. She'll know, you know, she knows everything's okay. It just might be a little different. So that's the way we kind of deal with it. And it, I don't know.
Good.
So.
My brother takes care of Vivi, so we haven't had that situation where he can cower and give her medicine and do all that.
Yeah.
But that probably really helped the Andy for us and Vivi.
Oh,
goodness.
Einstein.
What's she doing?
Huh? Einstein. She wants more than
you. I heard you say, you're all done.
Oh, that was my cue. I missed it.
You see that? Did
you see that myself?
You want some? Here. Einstein, this really, you've had enough nuts. Now I'm going to have to start giving you something else because this is ridiculous. Here. Here, Beach, here's a little one.
I want some.
You want some? Here. It's a nut. Pumpkin seed. I said you want some cantaloupe.
That's good. That's right over there. That's Einstein. Did you mean Einstein?
It is good. I
mean, good Einstein. She's sweet.
You doing so good?
Einstein, get over here. Up here where you are. I know you're going to go down there and get the. Come here, up here.
Is that good stuff? It's a strawberry. And it's pretty one. Strawberry.
Jeff have a long way to drive for work?
No, 15 minutes maybe.
Not much said, but sweet.
I'm trying to get
I'll get some stuff.
Maybe watch them.
Who's taking your looks?
Can you take it?
Maybe you can move it yourself.
Here's your piece.
Now, he, at the plant's just, no traffic either, and he can go away, that, you know, you have to get on freeway. So if he doesn't want
You're all done?
That's nice during the few days we have it, it does ice up and stuff. He usually still goes into work because nobody else goes in any more time. But that's only maybe two, three times a year.
It's amazing when your coworkers like you're not too good. She said one coworker, she said, are you coming into work tonight? I'd lie sometimes and say no, because I knew if I said I was, she'd come in too, and it's like, that's helpful to me. I'm here late, so it's like, concentrating. She's one of those people that are, I got this done, I got that done, and just like constantly barraging me with her job, you know.
You're all done?
What school did y'all go to, which one graduated?
I went to Southern Illinois University.
Okay.
I started there when And I went to lecture where the guest speaker, you know, I was majoring in art, and he said, what are you doing here studying art in college? You need to be like out drawing and, you know, if you want to do ad, drawing for advertisers, you need to, you know, start in the mailroom at an ad agency, and if you want to do, you know, art therapy, you need to be in psychology classes, not art classes, and he's like just, you know, putting everybody down for a certain particular class.
Saying you're wasting your time.
Yeah, and so it's just like kind of
You're all done?
A shift for me of, maybe he's got something to do that. No, I really wasn't sure I was gonna do it or anything. It's just, wanted to be a veterinarian, of course, and I worked for veterinarians for a while, and it's just too much sadness with it.
Oh, no kidding.
It's too way too many of these animals.
Yeah, I don't know, I couldn't, I thought about that too for a while, and I just, it takes a special person to work in any kind of,
Oh, I think so, yeah.
I don't know, I guess not good for training maybe, but, you know, you can't help everybody and
I have a strong stomach, but it's like hard kind of separating, the caring from that, you know, it's just like, it would make me sick, but it would make me sad, and I just couldn't.
Oh, some of the things I believe you read on Facebook and the internet about abuse and the radio and the TV, some of the things people do to animals, it's just
Ridiculous.
That's what I think about in TVs.
What do you think would be that?
She had a comment though.
Yeah, it's just incredible. I just can't imagine why people
get pets if they're not kind of normal.
Yeah,
I don't get that either. It's we had our little Lynn dog, our little dachshund dog. I don't even know what they did to that dog because when we got him, he was a little basket case. He'd be okay, but as soon as you take him out to go to the bathroom, as soon as he was done going to the bathroom, he got going to like seizures, like
it's like he's
yelping. So you know, it was pretty clear to us that obviously somebody had beat him, you know, after he went to the bathroom, but. I've known people that have had trouble with dogs and mistreated their dogs or hit their dogs. I've never seen anything like that where a dog just and he was like his eyes would roll back in his head and just
he's very steep. It's not like he could hurt you because it's so tiny.
It took probably a year before he completely stopped doing it. It's been a long time since he's had any kind
of. The first few times I'd be walking him and his. After he'd go, he'd go into that state and kind of run to the back, like, what happened? Did he get hurt? I was just like, I don't know what's wrong with him.
And it took about three or four times before it made the connection out. Somebody's obviously abused him, severely abused him. I mean, I've never seen anything like that. I've known a lot of people, you know, that they just have trouble. It's hard to housebreak, but you have to have a lot of patience and tolerance, and it doesn't do any good to.
And more scary is he's sneaking her, so then that's gonna make her more angry.
And he's still a little sneaky, but not nearly bad as he used to be. He's real good now. Yeah, but when he was younger, you know, he'd sneak off somewhere, you know, to find a place to go, because he's and so scared. You always know he did, because he'd come back in with like a little basket case. He's all like, you know, nervous, and you'd say, "Wait, what's wrong with him? Why is he acting like that?" Oh, yeah, he's done something wrong, and he can't hide it in his face, you know.
So, but he's okay now.
Yeah, so he's well adjusted now. He's but it was.
Somebody probably did. That was their form of.
Yeah, when we got him, I found him out, like, actually in the middle of Main Street. He was just walking in the little Main Street. He had, like, it was, like, almost just like a shoelace. Someone had tied him up with a shoelace outside. And so he was dragging this shoelace tied around his neck. And there were these people out in the middle of the street trying to catch him. And so I got out of my car, and this guy must have been like 6'5" and 280 pounds. And he reaches down to pick him up, and the dog is a little, and he was even littler then, you know, bit him. And he's like, "Don't, get back, everybody. It bites, it bites."
I looked at him and I said, "That's
I thought I'm gonna hurt you." And I grabbed him up, and he bit on me too, but it was like he could just barely feel it.
Even
now, he can't break the skin. He just can't break the skin. It was just so funny because the guy was like massive, and he was like afraid of a little dog. And then as soon as I had him, he goes to his truck, and he brings out this big, huge, thick rope, and like wraps around his neck, ties it off a little tight. Oh, and then around his mouth, he like muzzled his, and tied his mouth shut, and wrote a big like square knot to tie it off around his.
So is that when you took him?
Yeah, we took him. We put up signs, you know, has anybody, you know, lost his dog, and a picture of him. And you wouldn't believe how many people would just, like, straight up call up and lie and say it's their dog. I guess because he was a full-bred dachshund, miniature dachshund, and, you know, where we're at, you know, those are
$600
dogs. I bet they're probably even more in the cities and stuff, but. Oh, we have people call and go, "Yeah, I think you got my dog. When can I come get it?" And we're like, "Well, can you tell us what gender?" And then every time they'd be, she's a female." And well, no. And then they guess the gender, go, "A male." Go, "So is he a neuter?" And then, yeah.
Did you ask him what he was tied up with? I mean,
we said what color collar he was wearing.
Just like the vice president, I mean the presidential first lady debate.
Yeah. Right. And what color? A lot of times they say black because his dachshund picture of black. He's kind of reddish brown all over, and he's got a little white patch on his chest, but he had no black on him at all.
So people wouldn't have done that.
Yeah, and there was one lady. She must have called like three or four times, and then tried to change her voice, and then she, because she was learning more. Like, well. Not a female, so I know it's a male. He's not neutered, or so we know he's not neutered. And then she had like one of her sons or some guy, sounded like a really young guy, call. And you could hear her right in the background, like coaching him what to say. And finally, then she's like, "Well, I just really like to have that dog." And we're like, "Well,
no,
not you. I can give it to a serial liar and fraud." You know, I mean, that dog really did belong to somebody. I wouldn't do it again, knowing what we knew now and how he had been treated. We would.
Yeah, that last dog we found, we weren't looking for the original owner, so we were just like, "Well, like, it's a puppy, they couldn't keep him contained, he's loaded with fleas and he had scars all over his back." I asked my friends about what the scars were, they said it looked like he had outgrown a harness. And like, I had a hard time even just finding a collar that fit him because he was so tiny. Like,
yeah.
They must have put a harness on him immediately.
Oh.
So then we have a room, and we have the little dog kept him. He's a good boy.
How old is he, do you think?
They thought he was a year. I mean, he was six.
Yeah, Yeah, that was the other question that people would buy through this. So how old is he? And they go, 3 years old. We're like, no. Well, he's younger than that. It's like, well, these are not like trick questions. They're really simple, basic questions. People, if it's their dog, and then we had one person who legitimately thought he might be, bought the her son, and as soon as they saw him, that you could just see the sadness. You know, it's not him.
He was told by the guys.
Well, at least the kids can tell the truth.
Yeah. I think. I mean, that was just. It shocked me. I didn't expect that so many people. I mean, we must have had like 6 or 8 different people call trying to convince us that he was their dog.
Yes. Our neighborhood, we always have dogs that have gotten out or gotten loose. Even though you're supposed to be put. I was doing yard work one day, and this little guy came up and wouldn't let me touch him. He had the collar and tags on, but didn't let me touch him. Well, I had some lunch meat in here, and slowly but surely got him won over his trust.
That's wrapped around the
neck. Yeah, and then he just kind of rolled over in submission. And I was down on the ground with my iPhone, punching in the phone number, got the woman, and they came. We don't have a fenced yard, so I just had to keep him in my garage. And then I found a kitty one day out in the bushes. That's what we do.
That's fun.
Anyway, found a kitty and didn't know what to do with the cat. It was a little kitten. I'm not a cat. I don't know anything about cats. And so I got it, put it in a box, put it in the car, and took it down to the SPCA and walked.
We've got people to meet with. They're meeting together, right? They're meeting us at the same time. We're in Austin. We got that distance, and it's a little bit longer drive from here to Austin than it is from Austin.
Yeah, it's an hour and a half, I think, from Austin.
Yeah, that might be something to consider. That way we can get there a little later today. He's not working at McDonald's.
No, but he has a good job, and
it'd actually probably be harder to get off.
And he's at he just was it really this worked out great, because last week he was gone practically the whole week in Tampa on business. So.
doesn't really know when to retire, so that's, I guess, a good
thing. Well, that's a good thing, as long as you like it.
He reminds me a lot of my uncle. He's an engineer for GM for years. Mm-hmm. So he helped design like an atomic clock for one of their cars. And,
really?
I'm still not even sure they're using it, but it was a patent that he got. He was really proud of for mm-hmm. engineering that went into that.
Yeah, back when he did it, that was a big deal. Nowadays, yeah. That would be simple. But back then, I mean, I think it was like in the 80s, right? It was a long
time. Oh, yeah. Right, in the 70s. Yeah, it was quite a bit older than he got there. I used to go up and visit once, and he was going to sell champagne. So he'd be an engineer. My aunt was working in a cadaver lab at the war, and she showed us, earlier a dead body in the family. Really stuck with me. And she kept talking about, as soon as I work him through school and he gets this good job, then I'm done. I'm going to work him out. And so she's like a perpetual student. She's got 10 bachelor's
degrees. Wow, she's like going to school.
Yeah.
I never liked
going to
school that much.
No, not that much.
I like learning, but the whole
school thing. I think she finally stopped doing it a few years back.
Well, my background after college is mostly human resources, but then I'm kind of like, yeah, I met Jeff. I'm okay, bye-bye. Yeah, we got married. And then I started my own business. I had a gift business for, about 10 years. But I operated out of my house. I took it on the internet. It was on the internet, and I had about 3 locations in the Metroplex.
Oh,
it was like gift malls. You could take your stuff into the mall and set up an area, and that was your little store. And now those have kind of gone to the wayside. You don't see so many of them anymore. So.
But you're doing it in the heyday.
I was doing it in the heyday. I sold Beanie Babies.
Oh, my mom was a big Beanie Baby.
Beanie Babies,
she
brought.
She bought some from you because she was like.
Okay.
She was a collector.
So yeah.
She had a room full of.
Beanie Babies and my business furnished most of this house. That's why I did it. So,
possible.
The Beanie Baby bubble. Yeah, it like soared in value there for a while.
Yeah, I did that and several other collectibles in the 90s when collectibles were so popular. I was in Boyd's Bears, Beanie Babies, Webkinz later. That was sort of my swan song. Webkinz was the first interactive internet toy for kids.
Oh.
You bought this toy, it had a number on it, it had a secret code, and then they could go online. And online was the plush equivalent, or the digital equivalent of the plush toy.
Oh, man.
And you could, you play the game and buy your little toy. It was a kitty cat, buy it fish to eat and, play with the toy. A few points and stuff. Those were very popular, so I sold a bunch of those. Candles and cards and all that other stuff, too.
Mm.
Not on eBay, those I sold locally. I even had a little parrot on my website. I had a little parrot store. I sold parrot collectibles for people.
I guess you have a little crochet ring.
Oh, yeah, let me show.
We have one, too.
Did you get it from the Birdie Buddies?
We got it as a gift. Birthday present, so
it's
more for us than for her.
I have this sitting out because I want to.
It's a little bit different.
Yeah,
it's a little
different.
This lady did it. I don't know. I want to do a video of it and Einstein, and I just haven't had a chance yet. She's from Australia. Let me see, is that one? Yeah, from Australia.
Came a long way.
Yeah. She makes them when she's commuting back and forth to work on the train.
That's an animal. It's supposed to look like a baby bird, not Einstein.
What you eating over there, Einstein? Mind your manners, goodness.
You're so good, Bee Burgers. Isn't Einstein sweet? She's talk. You need to check out her door here pretty soon.
Y'all ready to do that? Let me get Einstein off. Einstein, can maybe sit on your drawer?
Sure.
Can I come see me?
Bye-bye.
Oh, bye-bye, maybe. And I can
I've already talked.
Have already talked?
She's not here, but she's here late for a little bit. Little birds talk, that's right.
Little bird talks. Einstein, you want
Smart birds talk, don't they?
Nuts over here?
Did you hear this one? She said they got a little bird, that little bird's smart.
No, I didn't hear her say that.
Yeah.
Yeah, a little bird, that little bird's smart.
Yeah, they got a little bird.
Baby's smart.
He's so funny.
Okay.
Birds.
I'm gonna get her off of here. Here, Einstein, here's a nut. Can you come see me? I'll bring a few pies, won't you? Come here, up, up. Come on, see me?
Yeah.
Here's a nut. Come on. I'm here, old Einstein.
You can kill him.
You silly, come see me.
They got a little bird, that bird's smart.
Good girl. Oh, come on, smart boy. Good girl. Yeah. Here we go. Here we go. Let's pick that up.
You gonna film with the big camera?
I was just gonna use the GoPro.
Oh, okay.
Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.
Where are you going? Where are you going, Bees?
The strawberries?
You going somewhere without us?
Can't you strawberry?
Here, I saw, let me just move you over. Well, we'll just fly on the camera.
Pretty bird.
Over here.
You got your camera too, right?
Did you need the food? Did you need the food in the door, okay?
It's okay, we can clean it up.
Several years.
They go, what, every 3 minutes?
Einstein doesn't, she holds it for some reason. I don't know what the deal is with that. Oh, not gonna happen. No.
Lazy.
A fly?
Yeah, some fly.
Good TV. Now send me that.
The guy who made this is a real success story. He was a mountain biker, and he didn't have a really small quality video camera. He could go out on the trails and stuff. He designed his own, and his fellow mountain biker people were like, "Oh, can you make me one?" I think that's sweet.
That's sweet.
TV on the floor.
And so he started making them for mountain bikers. I was like, this is a great idea. There's a lot of people in sports and in movement things that would like something like that. So he started a little business. And then the first bird, didn't have a whole lot of feature, but he sold tens of thousands of them. It was mostly sporting enthusiasts at that time. Well, then reality TV people, because they're always on the move and they needed cameras in a lot of different places, they started picking them up. And I think it wasn't the Amazing Race. I think they did them too, but there was it the Big Catch or there's that fishing one, the one where they dangerous, the deadly catch.
Oh, yeah.
And they were kind of ones that started popularizing using this camera in their actual production video. Once it was actually on TV and people were using it. I think they said there's 70 shows now on TV that use these cameras. And they're to them, these are almost disposable because they're
I know. Okay, so how can you see what you're taking on video?
Well, you can get an LCD thing that'll go on the back of it, but otherwise it has autofocus. And right now I have it on a wide zoom, so it almost creates a fishbowl kind of fisheye kind of look. So it has three different settings of you can do narrow or medium or wide, and you can pick your resolutions and stuff. He sold 3 million of these things.
Wow.
And, obviously went from being just a mountain biker guy to now.
One of our friends used
very, very well.
On his jet ski and we're going out on the houseboat before we did it. He took a trip.
Go ahead, you can go.
Well, he drove around on his jet ski using one of those. And one of the days he's like, here's what the lake looks like. Because he was all excited about the houseboat. He's like, think we'll go on this cove and then maybe that one doesn't work out.
So you videotape the lake and then put it up on YouTube.
Yeah, that's amazing.
Pick where we wanted to park the houseboat. That houseboat thing is fun.
Yeah, the water slides.
I like those ones. I've seen them before where they have a really complex water slide or loops or not really loops, but spirals.
Einstein. I just ran out of battery.
Do you know that Einstein, he
I had a blast. It's been a good 24 hours, almost 24 hours.
Time goes by fast when you have fun. That's
I
true.
know, I know.
And thank you so much for letting us invade your space.
Oh.
In your drawer.
Thanks, Einstein.
Thanks for just coming to see us.
Oh, that's great. I'm so glad we did.
Are you familiar with Sharky, Pitbull Sharky on YouTube? I'll have to send you her, her channel. Cute girl. She lives in Houston. She, just has chickens and ducks and all kinds of, I don't know where they live in Houston, my outlast.
It's a pitbull Sharky. It's a...
It's a pitbull.
Okay.
It's a pitbull dog. The tamest, most docile dog you'd ever want to see. Let me,
pull it up real quick on the iPad.
Anyway, they are gonna come see us.
Nice.
I'll just have to send it to you later. And I don't know that I can see them, but I'm sure I did. Well, yeah, I have BBs. Yeah, I have your email.
We are BBs.
Yeah. where my iPad is, I guess I have to put it down somewhere. Anyway, real docile little pit bull and allows these little baby chicks and ducks to walk all over him. And, anyway, just really cute. She's from like Romania or she's an immigrant here. I guess she married some guy here. Really cute. They were in Kansas, so that's really neat. But they didn't. It didn't pan out. They were going to come to a car race.
Mm-hmm.
BB, it was so nice of you to come see me. I need to help your mom and dad to pack up here. If I can do anything.
Thanks for shaking us out. I can tell you.
Oh, Jeff did that. Yeah. Just. BB, is this broom going to bother you?
It's just never ending thing, isn't it?
I
sweetie pie.
And little Einstein heard Evie growl.
Oh, I'm sorry,
Einstein. No, just her feathers on her head kind of went up like, ooh, what was that?
Yeah, Gracie does that too.
Yeah.
The growl. That's usually what I get. So last night was real unusual. I think she was probably just kind of worn out. Like, I don't have enough in me to go. You're a good bird.
You are a good bird, babe. You're a sweet bird. You're smart. You're smart. You're smart. Yeah. That's good stuff in there. It's good stuff. Good stuff. Good stuff. I like the perch. I do like the perch. I sure do. That's a cool perch. And son, would you like a perch like that? I don't know that you really need one, but yep. They're all done up, John. What'd you say, Beeps? Gonna step up? Talk about jobs.
One berry.
One berry? Good bird. Fort Worth.
There's a talking Dixie. There's a talking Dixie.
Wanna go have some berries?
Want some berries?
She must have known I made her growl.
No, she just does that with new people that just, you know, thinking, oh, is she gonna take me off my perch if I'm where I don't want to go? Okay, sweetie. Here, you made a mess over here. Here you go. Floor down. Okay, Beeps. I'm gonna put this on the charger. Want to step up? Come see me? Are you happy? You want carrot? That's good. It's good stuff. Good job, Phoebe. Look, Einstein, Phoebe's eating carrots. Want a pea pod? Want this one? Want a pea pod? Want broccoli? Want some broccoli? Ooh, that's got water on it. Want some broccoli?
Are we going on a road trip?
Birds, you look awful relaxed. There's, yeah, how you doing, Beeps? You're the Beeps, though. Yeah, I'm not the Beeps. You're the Beeps.
Oh, we added that, yeah.
You added that?
Yeah, that's from our weight bench, so. We just unscrewed it. Yeah, because it just tipped over too. So whenever she went to an edge, and there's a toy stand cup on there. And first she took off the toy stand, and she climbed the very top of that and find a way to to climb down and stuff. And, and then the cup, she hang upside down so she could calm down.
Yeah, then I had to take the cup off. Let me show you mine. I can't even remember what the perch part looks like now, but.
We usually put like a paper plate too, like cut a circle hole in the middle.
Yeah, that's, yeah, I, oh, it's the same, almost. Oh, mine's a little smaller. But I just put up a brown newspaper and they all screwed the circle on the cup. And I just put rubber, but this is what we use when she's in bed with us. I don't want to get up and put her over here poop.
Yeah, exactly.
She just poops on the, let's see, we're watching TV.
She's got a.
Oh, yeah. But it doesn't have a weight and it's.
We had to add that weight to the shelf.
Yeah, we very rarely use this. On a few road trips and.
It can be handy, so you just want to cover in the middle of the people, like on a coffee table.
Yeah. That's mainly what we use. Einstein never tipped it over though, but weight's a good,
Yeah, it's also a lot of heavy.
I'm not sure your mailman was happy with us.
Ooh.
Oh, did she already come?
Yeah.
Well, probably what happened with the balloons yesterday either, but she'll get over it.
Yeah. It happens.
Yeah.
I think that's just about everything.
Let me help y'all carry some stuff out and.
I have a little Ziploc bag that I see in this place. Do you have one?
Oh, yeah.
Take.
I have my sandwich or snacks. Yeah, take whatever you want, because I'm sure you'll need some.
Thank you so much.
Hi. So you're checking out the Texas for the day?
4 hours and 9 minutes, Steve.
Do you need water for the road?
She's got a little bottle.
Yeah, we got.
How about you guys? Y'all want to take a couple bottles?
Would you mind?
No, here.
I have a little bag, so. Water, do you want to take a color? You little prima.
Prima.
A little bit helps, huh?
Drink your water.
Put on your head? Don't get diarrhea.
Yeah, it's amazing how little water they really do drink.
Yeah.
I guess they just.
She drank quite a bit at the restaurant last night.
Oh, did you?
There's something about like people glasses too, I think she just, what they see you drinking out of.
Einstein just loves to drink out of the kitchen faucet. And in fact, when she broke her beak, were you in on, did you know about that?
No, I didn't know where that broke her beak.
Just the tip of it?
Yeah. Don't know how it happened. She was in here. Jeff and I were in our respective computer places. And Jeff came out here and noticed little droplets of blood on the floor and on the sink. And she had broken the tip off. And I found it on the kitchen rug. And by the time we saw her, the bleeding had stopped. But she was just sitting there, you know, really quiet and everything. I felt bad I wasn't there when it happened. But anyway, she was doing fine, but it was real sore for a few days, you know, a couple of days. So I cooked her, you know, roasted sweet potatoes, all soft foods. And I knew that she could go, you know, a day or two without food, but water was a problem because she didn't want to dip her beak into the water. So that's how I did, got water in her, was that I would, at the kitchen sink, I would hold my finger out, you know, the flow. So, and then she would, she would like on the side of her beak drink water. So.
It must have really been tender.
It was tender for about a day or two.
Did you have to pay for the vet?
No, online I looked and Facebook people, nothing they can do.
Yeah, bleeding's the most dangerous part of that once that stops.
Yeah, it was just an eighth of an inch, just not even eighth. I mean, I measured, it was maybe 3/16 or whatever, you know. It was a tiny bit, and we don't know how it happened. You know, she just, the only thing we can think, somewhere on the drawer, maybe Jeff seems to think she got it caught possibly in this little area right here.
Oh, I guess since then she yanked it.
Yeah, she yanked it. But there was no blood here, but there was blood down there. And then we think she probably got up there and walked this way. And there were splatters too, because she kept shaking, you know.
Yeah.
And so there were little splatters of blood on the floor.
Scary, you're all healed up now.
Oh, yeah, she's fine now, but.
I've heard they can bruise their beaks too. And somebody dropped their bird's out of hand when they're outside and landing on their driveway. And so now he has a big brown spot on the beak. It's because, oh, don't worry, it's just a bruise. You know, it'd be tender and everything. But it's like, you know, on the top part, on the bottom.
Oh, my goodness. I never heard of that.
Yeah, like
blood flow. Oh, yeah, there's. It's a like a spongy, not spongy, but it's a real porous.
I guess you got a good look at it.
No, I'll show you the piece. There was hardly anywhere, yeah, you couldn't see a thing. But I'll show you the piece that came off. I think I still have it.
The parent sees it.
These will.
Yeah, Einstein's never had to have her beak ground.
Ours is the first, but it's when it gets the layers, like, yeah, on the side.
We're not going to do that.
The new vet isn't.
Yeah. And it's amazing, she doesn't need it ground because she doesn't chew a lot.
Did she not climb around as much as she did?
Because they use their beaks a lot.
That's right, yeah. She did not climb. She was quiet for like 3 days. She started eating like after the first day and a half, you know, a little bit better, using her beak more. But I just fed her through the side of her beak. And I fed her things that, you know, crackers and things that we could dip in water, you know, wash the salt off, that makes soft. And then there's video of her, I think on either blog or Facebook, of her eating, holding it and eating it on the side. So she.
Some person did get a disorder of front teeth or something.
Yeah. But some of the Facebook comments I got were so cute, you know, all maybe kind of like a broken tooth,
yeah.
You know, whatever. But,
am
yeah.
I safe too?
I was on my hands and knees. I knew it either went down the sink or there was a part somewhere in my kitchen.
Yeah.
So you can imagine looking for that on my countertop. I was like, kind of like this, you know, because you could see more things that I love. And then I got down on my hands and knees, and it was on the mat.
Wow.
And when I brushed the mat with my hand, it was like panning for gold, really. That's it. Yeah.
What size t-shirt do you?
Oh, yeah, how much are they?
Oh, you know, we're not selling them.
Okay.
Friends.
I'll take probably a large, and Jeff, so what, an extra large?
In purple?
Yeah. Yeah. What other colors do you have? Purple and
red and blue. And then
there's a light blue and a dark blue.
And he wants the purple. I'll take the red.
Okay.
I'll do a red. Thank you.
I'll close it back.
Yeah. I just, with all the activity, I just thought I'd shut it.
That's where your strawberry wound up. It's pretty simple.
Yeah.
Looked everywhere. I was like, yeah. She talks about strawberries a lot.
Yeah. Yeah, Einstein very rarely will eat a strawberry.
We when we first gave her a whole strawberry, you know, with the stem taken off, she'd sit there and pick all the little seeds off.
I know. Yeah.
It's so ridiculous.
Yeah.
You guys are so cute. I know. Did I take your berry? You just got ready to go in your packing bird. You sure you don't want some of that?
Last call for alcohol. That holds berries. I mean, it wasn't designed for that, but it sure does a good job.
Yeah, there was nothing in it originally. People look for things of like good berry size. I know little stars are on that side, but obviously not stirring anymore. This has been a favorite with both Grace and me, because once they figure it out, they're just like, and you can lock it two different ways.
Like, I've never seen that either. I have to.
One direction it goes.
Cool.
Yeah, Dr. Foster just sent up the kids with the barrel finding.
Okay. Yeah, but that would be fun. I'll have to.
Yeah, and this one had the drawers. They have a big one that's just three drawers. Mm-hmm. This one, every other layer was the doors were slid in through here. But they was like all the way out, so she just pull them out
and
they got them. Yeah, and they actually got lost in the drawings and newspapers. She's in her little junk toy drawer. You know.
Yeah.
Yeah, you did so good.
You did good, BB. You did real good. We had a good time. Good time. Come back and see me. Come back and see me anytime. You're always welcome.
Thank you so much. You're wonderful hostess.
Oh, well, y'all are great guests. We had a blast.
Yeah,
so you have to drive a long way to see me.
It's been fun in Texas, Peter.
And you've got an adventure awaits. South Texas. A cool front's coming in, but y'all will be. It may catch up with you. I hope so. I hope the weather cools down a little bit for you.
Yeah, how cold does it get at night?
This time of the year. It can get cold. A front can come through and it can get cold, but I don't suspect it will. Maybe in the 50s.
Okay, that's not too bad. We have a little space heater and that keeps us warm. Like we were down in the mid 40s one night and it was a little chilly, but she's covered up and we, you know, make the area smaller that it's heating and that's
Very good.
Einstein,
I'll carry this out to you guys. Einstein, you be good there? Say goodbye. Come back again.
Do you mind if I dump our newspapers here too?
No.
Okay.
Great.
Oops, sorry, Einstein.
That's really good. You going to pack a bird? You're bringing it fun in Austin, yes you are. Destination Austin! Woo!
Y'all will have fun in Austin. And how many people are going to see you guys?
We have another bird and her family, so it's another couple that has a bird. And then another couple that we're going to stay the night with.
That doesn't have a bird?
They do not have
a bird.
Okay.
A lot of non-bird people are friends of babies. I don't, it's hard for me to keep track of who owns who and who's just a, God, there's so many people.
Yeah.
I try to make notes, but then I can't remember all of them.
We didn't know for this trip it was you and Shadow.
We go see Shadow. Oh yeah, Shadow is the.
Yeah, that's Shadow's bird. And they have a doggy too. They have a sweet bee.
And Judy.
Oh, yeah.
Does Judy not have a bird?
She does not have a bird.
No. Okay.
She's one of the longest time friends there.
But she's looking so good.
Oh, yeah.
Seeing you guys.
I like talking.
You like to talk? Okay.